Welcome to Edupedia World. In this video, we will learn about liberalization and what economic reforms taken by the government under liberalization. Liberalization. Prior to 1991, there were large number of government restrictions in India in the areas of licensing, import and export trade, dealings in foreign exchange, etc. In July 1991, a package of economic reforms was announced, which marked the beginning process of liberalization in India. What exactly the meaning of liberalization? Liberalization means removal of entry and growth restrictions on the private sector. Liberalization involves deregulation and reduction of government controls and greater autonomy. Autonomy means freedom of private investment to make economy more competitive. Under this process, business is given free hand and is allowed to run on commercial lines. The purpose of liberalization was to unlock the economic potential of the country by encouraging private sector and multinational corporations to invest and expand, and to introduce much more competition into the economy and creating incentives for increasing efficiency of operations. The economic reforms taken by the government under liberalization include the following. First is industrial sector reforms, next financial sector reforms, tax reforms, foreign exchange reforms, and trade and investment policy reforms. We will discuss each of the reform in detail in the coming slide. Okay, first reform is industrial sector reforms. In order to make necessary reforms in the industrial sector, the government introduced its new industrial policy on July 24, 1991. The various measures under industrial policy reforms include reduction in industrial licensing. The new policy abolished industrial licensing for all the projects except for a short list of industries like liquor, defense equipments, industrial explosive, etc. No licenses were needed to set up new units or expand or diversify the existing line of manufacture. However, license is required for certain industries related to security and strategic consideration. Next point is decrease in role of public sector. One of the striking features was the substantive reduction in the role of the public sector in the future industrial development of the country. The number of industries exclusively reserved for the public sector reduced from 17 to following three industries, which are defense equipments, atomic energy generation, and railway transport. Next point is de-reservation under small-scale industries. Many goods produced by small-scale industries have now been de-reserved. The investment ceiling on plant and machinery for small undertakings enhanced to rupees 1 crore. In many industries, the market was allowed to determine the prices through forces of the market and not by directive policy of the government. And the last point is monopolies and restrictive trade practices, which is also called MRTP Act. With the introduction of liberalization and expansion schemes, the requirement for large companies to seek prior approval for expansion, establishment of new undertakings, merger, amalgamations, etc. were eliminated. So these are the industrial sector reforms under liberalization. Now we come to financial sector reforms. Financial sector includes financial institutions like commercial banks, investment banks, stock exchange operations, and foreign exchange market. The financial sector in India is controlled by the central bank and Reserve Bank of India, RBI. The reforms introduced under financial sector are First is change in role of RBI. The role of RBI was reduced from regulator to facilitator of financial sector. As a result, financial sector was allowed to take decisions on many matters without consulting the RBI. Next point is origin of private banks. The reform policies led to the establishment of private sector banks, Indian as well as foreign. For example, Indian banks like ICICI and foreign banks like HSBC increased the competition and benefited the consumers through lower interest rates and better services. Next point is increase in limit of foreign investment. The limit of foreign investment in banks was raised to around 51%. Foreign institutional investors, FII, such as merchant bankers, mutual funds, and pension funds, were now allowed to invest in Indian financial market. Though banks have been given permission to generate resources from India and abroad, certain aspects have been retained with the RBI to safeguard the interest of the account holders and the nation. And the last point under financial sector reforms are ease in expansion process. Banks were given freedom to set up new branches after fulfillment of certain conditions without the approval of the RBI. So these are some of the reforms under financial sectors. Next, we come to tax reforms. Tax reforms refers to reform in government taxation and public expenditure policies, which are collectively known as its fiscal policy. Taxes are of two types. First is direct taxes, which consist of taxes on income of individuals as well as profits of business enterprises. For example, income tax, taxes on individual income, and corporate tax, taxes on profit of companies. Next is indirect taxes, which refers to those taxes which affect the income and property of persons through their consumption expenditure. Indirect taxes are generally imposed on goods and services. For example, sales tax, VAT, custom duty, etc. The major tax reforms made are reduction in taxes. Since 1991, there has been a continuous reduction in income, and corporate tax has high tax rates were an important reason for tax evasion. It is now widely accepted that moderate rates of income tax encourage savings and voluntary disclosure of income. Next point is reform in indirect taxes. Considerable reforms had been made in indirect taxes to facilitate establishment of common national market for goods and commodities. Next reform is simplification of process. In order to encourage better compliance on the part of taxpayer, many procedures have been simplified. So these are the major reforms under tax reform and liberalization. Foreign exchange reforms. The important reforms made in the foreign exchange market are devaluation of rupee. What is devaluation of rupee? It is the reduction in the value of domestic currency by the government. To overcome balance of payment crisis, which is BOP, the rupee was devalued against foreign currencies. This led to an increase in the inflow of foreign exchange. Next point is market determination of exchange rate. The government allowed rupee value to be free from its control. As a result, market forces of demand and supply determine the exchange value of the Indian rupee in terms of foreign currency. So these are the two major reforms under foreign exchange reforms. Now we come to the last reform, that is trade and investment policy reforms. Before 1991, a lot of restrictions, that is high tariffs and quotas, were imposed on imports to protect the domestic industries. However, this protection reduced the efficiency and competitiveness of domestic industries and led to their slow growth. So the reforms in the trade and investment policy were initiated. that is to increase the international competitiveness of industrial production, to promote foreign investments and technology into the economy, to promote efficiency of local industries and adoption of modern technologies. The important trade and investment policy reforms include removal of quantitative restrictions on imports and exports. That is under the new economic policy, that is the NEP, quantitative restrictions on imports and exports were greatly reduced. For example, quantitative restrictions on imports of manufactured consumer goods and agricultural products were fully removed from April 2001. Next reform was removal of export duties, that is, export duties were removed to increase the competitive position of Indian goods in the international market. Next is reduction in import duties. Import duties were reduced to improve the position of domestic goods in the foreign market. And last policy reform is relaxation in import licensing system. The import licensing was abolished except in case of hazardous and environmentally sensitive industries. This encouraged domestic industries to import raw material at better prices, which raised their efficiency and made them more competitive. So these are the reforms which were under liberalization. Thank you for watching Edupedia World videos.